So horseshoe crabs have a really high natural mortality. Things like building the seawalls and dredging, a lot of human factors, building jetties, things like that, have impacted the horseshoe crab because they like these kind of really nice, fine-grained, sandy beaches. So when people build seawalls, you know, the water comes right up to the seawall, and then the horseshoe crabs don't have the nice, shallow water to nest in. This one is unfortunately a dead female. You can tell I don't have a male to compare it to, but she's on the larger side. I don't want to touch her too much because dead horseshoe crabs are one of the most disgusting smells in the world. But you can see right here that her front claws, the pincer, like the rest of her claws, she doesn't have the boxing gloves. That's how I could tell it was a female, that and her size. Again, the official way is you can see the two, hers are more tannish, but the two white slits, which is where she releases eggs from, unlike the two white prongs that the male had. And her gills might be eaten a little, but you can see the books. It looks like the pages of a book if I'm trying to flip them, but they're kind of
sucks. What do you think killed her?
Based on the fact that, she does have a dent in her head, but usually dents and cuts and things like that won't kill a horseshoe crab. She does have some cuts in her. I still wouldn't contribute that to the cause of death. I would say that she probably just dried out. Does have a worm crawling on her, which might have impacted something. But usually a blow like this to the head will not kill a horseshoe crab. We've seen horseshoe crabs with their whole faces punched in. Not punched in, but you know, it looks like somebody literally just went like that.
Where's that from?
Where's what from?
The punches and the dents and the dings.
They could be from anything, really. They're pretty indestructible. I mean, if I were to go like this, I probably wouldn't even make a dent in it. They're probably from boats or, really, I don't even know. Anything falling on them. I would say boats, probably. We've seen horseshoe crabs that have, you know, an area this big, just straight through a hole, straight through their head, and they're still kicking around. So horseshoe crabs can sustain a lot, although they do have a very high natural mortality. I would say this one probably just dried out. So we did find her upside down, so she probably dried out. The thing with horseshoe crabs is a lot of people are really afraid of them, but they're completely harmless. This is not a stinger. Obviously, it's sharp. If you step on it, it will hurt, but they don't have the ability to kind of retract it and stick it out at you or anything like that. The sole purpose of the tail is that when they're flipped upside down, they unfold like this and they use it as a pivot to pivot themselves back and forth until they can flip themselves over. So the tail really is no purpose but to flip themselves over when they're upside down. These pincers, they have a pair of swimming pincers or claws all the way in the back. They use those really for walking. These pincers right here, they could do some damage. You see them pinching me right there. It doesn't really hurt. Sometimes if they get the skin just right, it'll hurt. But really, for the most part, completely harmless animals. These two little claws right here are called chelicera. Despite the name horseshoe crabs are actually more closely related to spiders and scorpions. Got another guy trying to meet with my foot right here. Just keeps running into it. A lot of times people think that those big scary fang-like things on spiders are their fangs, but they're actually just their chelicera, and that's what they eat with. This guy's really trying to meet with me.
Where's his mouth?
His mouth is actually right in between his legs. What they do is they take the food up with the chelicera, they pinch it and they place it in their mouths, and then they move these their legs back and forth. And the moving action of their legs pushes the food into their mouths. These thread-like area right here is called nathobases, and it kind of acts as their jaw. They grind up the food and then push it into their mouth. And horseshoe crabs eat pretty much anything. They're bottom feeding scavengers. They'll eat anything from small snails, clams, shells. They can crack shells with the chelicera. Slugs. Definitely more of a carnivore. I don't think they're herbivores at all, but they basically clean up the ocean floor. One other thing that I touched on earlier is the difference in colors. There's a few theories. There's really no way to age a horseshoe crab. It takes about 10 years for them to reach sexual maturity, and anywhere up to 20 years is their lifespan. The way that they usually age a horseshoe crab is by, as I said earlier, the epibionts that are on them. That means life growing on top of something else. Another way is by the color. And it's believed by horseshoe crab researchers that you can see he is a nice tan color. After horseshoe crabs molt, they look exactly like this. They're that nice tan color. Whereas she's a nice dark brown, almost black color, which would suggest that she's old and her shell used to look like this and has had time to become darker brown. However, as you can see with this female, she doesn't have any sort of epibionts on her, whereas he has a ton. So this plays into, you would think he was younger because he's this nicer color, but he's got epibionts and she doesn't. So it's really unclear on how to age a horseshoe crab based solely on color and epibionts.
I traveled to Mass Audubon at the Wellfleet Wildlife Sanctuary to learn more about the horseshoe crab and came away smitten. They are just incredible creatures of the ocean, older than almost any other animal. Beautiful in their own way, with life living on their shells. During our midnight check, we met a fisherman on the beach who asked us what we were doing. When we told him, he shared without prompting that our research is important because he remembered even 5 years ago the beach was so full of horseshoe crabs you couldn't walk without stepping on one. Now, sadly, there are only a few. It would be shameful, a true disaster, if after 400 million years, the horseshoe crab disappeared from New England shores. The research that the dedicated staff and volunteers at Mass Audubon and their regional partners are doing is essential to ensure that these ocean dwellers remain a part of the web of life forever.